In the ever-evolving landscape of sustainability, the resources and waste management sector stands at a crossroads. By adopting more circular processes and recycling efficiently, the industry can play a significant role in cutting greenhouse gas emissions. But as global concerns over climate change escalate, all industries must reduce their own carbon footprint. Currently, the resources and waste management sector makes up 6% of the UK's total greenhouse gas emissions. However, that figure masks the overall picture.
There has been a massive reduction in carbon emissions from this sector over the last 20 years of around 60%, and that's been driven largely by the move away from disposal to landfill.
With all emissions, there are easy fixes and more complicated ones. Emissions from waste collection and management are low-hanging fruit. These can be reduced by electrifying vehicle fleets and installing renewable power at waste facilities. Waste itself can be harnessed to produce renewable power. For example, these anaerobic digestion plants turn food waste into energy. Reducing operational emissions is essential, but the biggest element of the sector's emissions, almost two-thirds, is caused by landfill. And the main culprit here is methane, a greenhouse gas 84 times more potent than carbon dioxide, that is created by the decomposition of organic matter. So the biggest reduction in emissions can be achieved by reducing waste going to landfill in the first place. Increased recycling efficiency and waste prevention are key mechanisms here. But for old landfills, there's even technologies to tackle methane emissions.
One of the obvious innovations we've seen and developments across the sector has been the capture of landfill gas. The answer was 20 odd years ago to begin to install gas engines and gas collection systems. And they've got ever more efficient and make a real contribution towards renewable power in the UK.
The second largest source of emissions is from energy from waste. In fact, these emissions are the reason that greenhouse gas emissions have plateaued in recent years. Energy from waste has grown significantly, mostly as a result of the landfill tax. In 2010, it consumed just over 10% of the UK's residual waste. Over 80% went to landfill that year. Today, it consumes over 50%, with less than 40% going to landfill.
That's meant the sector's contribution to the UK's energy has gone from single figure percentages up to around about 10% of its renewable energy generation. However, there is always a downside as well, and about half of the inputs into these facilities are fossil fuel based, so plastics. We're beginning to see more of people looking at carbon capture, storage and utilisation.
At the moment, carbon capture and storage, or CCS, is fledgling, although the UK government has set aside £1 billion for its development. The third largest emitter within the waste sector, aside from wastewater, which is managed by the water industry, is compost. Even though it is one of the largest sources of greenhouse gas emissions in the industry, there are several reasons why we should not look to decrease composting. Unlike landfill, compost breaks down organic matter using oxygen, so it releases the much less potent carbon dioxide rather than methane. Compost is also an important source of fertilizer, and mitigates the use of synthetic fertilisers, which are responsible for over 2% of global emissions on their own. From avoiding landfill to reducing operational emissions, there are numerous ways that the resources and waste sector can reduce its greenhouse gas emissions.
The drive towards circular economy and net zero will actually come from a combination of service improvements, innovations and technology, better ways of managing materials, and better policies to actually drive us towards that.
The resources and waste management sector has made significant reductions in its emissions, but for us to reach net zero, further reductions must be made.